viewers, this is Pratik. Welcome back to Food Cafe. Today, I'm going to show you a very simplest way of making a pizza at home. So, to start with the pizza dough, we need flour. I have 1 cup of flour. I'm going to add entirely on my marble. Make a well so that your water doesn't come out and make your place messy. As you see, now I have a well here. Add your sugar, that is 15 grams. I have added 5 grams with the yeast so that it allows the yeast to activate. And I have 5 grams of salt. The salt, I'm gonna add the salt around the dough because if I add it in the middle, my yeast is gonna die, which I would not like to happen. I have my activated yeast. I'm using the dry yeast. For the dry yeast, all you need is take 15 grams of yeast and add very little amount of water and make it into a very fine paste. You just need to make it soft with your spoon, and then you have to add 5 grams of sugar into it and a pinch of flour and leave it aside for 15 to 20 minutes according to the room temperature. So now I'm gonna add the yeast to it. So now I'm gonna add my water in the middle. Just give a good mix of the sugar and yeast together. The best way to know that your yeast is activated is you would know it when you see a bowl, the yeast would be having bubbles and it would be multiplying vigorously, which would say that the yeast is activated. Now I'm adding my water. So keep on scraping a little bit of flour from the sides. And remember, never use your entire hand to make a dough, because by doing that, the only thing which you're doing is you're pressing the gluten and suffocating it, which would make your dough hard, which we do not like to have it. So now, as you see, I made a good paste of the flour, little by little, little by little. Now, as you see, my dough is almost ready. Play with your dough until it's perfectly done. You're gonna knead your dough until it's, I'll tell you the right time. So now I'm gonna add my olive oil. Olive oil, all you need like 2 spoons of olive oil. As you know, this is a pizza, so we're gonna make an Italian style pizza. Now, as you see, my dough is ready, but we are not yet ready because we need to give a very good kneading to this dough so that your dough would be perfectly ready to make a very good pizza at home. So now I'll show you how to knead your dough. All you need to is stop it with your left hand and give a nice rub on the dough. By doing this, your dough expands and the gluten which is inside would become elastic and would give you a very good dough. Now, as you see, my dough is almost ready. I'm gonna take a bowl, dust some flour, keep this dough into it, close it with a wet, damp cloth. By doing this, the dough will rest and it would allow the yeast to activate, and that would prove your dough. And once the dough is proved, I'm gonna show you what's gonna happen next. As you see, as the dough is perfectly fermented now, by giving a knockback, this would allow the extra air between the dough to go away, and by doing so, your dough would be perfect. Now I'm gonna give a knockback, fold it. As you see, now my dough is perfectly done. The extra air which is inside is all gone. Now, as you see, my dough is, I gave a very good knockback. Now it's time to portion it into 4 equal portions. For that, you need to spread your dough, make it like a sausage or a salami. By doing this, you can make 4 equal portions. Now portion it into 4 equal portions, and now it's time to make a very good roundel. For that, all you need is tuck your dough inside. While doing this, keep rolling and make it into a nice good shape. Now my portion dough is ready. Now I'm gonna sprinkle some semolina on my baking tray. By doing this, it would not allow your dough to stick. That's it. And now let's go ahead and spread our dough first. That's some flour. Now, as you see, my dough is perfectly ready. I've spread my dough into a round base. Now, it's time to tap your dough by leaving 1 inch. So by doing this, it would not allow your sauce to come out and make it messy. So as you see, I put this, same thing with this. You can spread the pizza dough as per your size. So I spread this into a 3 inch flat size. Once you do this, place it on your baking tray and leave it for another 10 minutes so that your pizza dough proofs, and then it's all set for baking. So now, as you see, my pizza is all ready. Now I'm gonna place it on the baking tray. Make sure you have left 1 inch at least so that it would allow your sauce not to go out. A little bit of semolina on top. So now it's time to dock your pizza. By doing this, it would not allow your pizza to become fluffy and uneven. This is very important. By doing this, your flat base would be flat. See that you give a nice good dot on all the sides. As you see, now it's all ready. Now leave it for 10 to 15 minutes and it's all set for baking. As you see, viewers, my pizza base is all ready. I have baked it at 150 for 4 minutes. As you know, it is just the base. There's no need to cook your bread completely. I have cooked it almost 3/4 done. As you see, my base is ready. Now, once it comes out of the oven, make sure you cool it. If you don't cool it, it's gonna have moisture in it and it will spoil your base very soon. So as it cools, take a cling wrap and wrap it completely, and you can store it and use it. The best way to store it is to freeze it, or if you're using it in for the next week, it can be in your fridge. So clean wrap your pizza and place it in the fridge. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please do subscribe and leave your comments.